Hello Nesties, I'm Princy and welcome back to my channel Angst Cadbury. Hope you all are doing great and I hope you all are comfortable out here. So recently I got a request on uploading a makeup tutorial. So recently I have done a makeup on this two-tone smoky eye. So I thought of sharing this tutorial with you guys. I created this two-tone smoky eye with a single eyeshadow palette. So if you are interested in knowing how I created this look, then do keep on watching. The first and important thing before applying makeup onto your skin is to apply moisturizer, because it will serve as a good primer. This will also help you give your makeup a good base to stick to and moisturize your skin. So make sure that you moisturize your skin before applying makeup, as it moisturization prevents your foundation look from looking caked on and keeps your skin healthy underneath your makeup. So moisturizing your lips are also important. So once done with the moisturization of our lips and our skin, our next step is to prep our face for the perfect makeup look or dewy look, so that our foundation doesn't look caked upon. So in order to create that perfect canvas, I am using this the One Illusion face primer from Oriflame. I recently purchased it from Snapdeal and since then it has been one of my favorite products. It helps me to even out the skin tone and extends the wear of my foundation and minimizes the appearance of the pores. So if you ask about my favorite foundation till date, then Jerry G Innocent foundation is one of my favorite till date, and I was lucky enough to get this foundation in my August 2016 fab bag and got a chance to try this foundation. It is innocently flawless and wickedly nourishing. It has non-masking and nourishing to the skin. Jerry G's exclusive water-based formula combines moisturizing benefits of the squalene oil from olives, green tea and white tea with radiant pigments that conceal in perfection and illuminate the complexion. It is completely weightless and hydrating, and of course glides on seamlessly and provides all day sheer to moderate coverage with a natural matte finish. It comes in two shades, that is light and medium, and I got the light shade. At first you can see that my face has turned white with it, but don't worry, at the end you will love the end result. Concealers has become one of my favorite nowadays, because recently I attended my cousin sister's marriage and there I haven't used any foundation or any highlighter, but I have used the concealer only in order to mask the dark circles or aging spots, large pores and other small blemishes visible on the skin. Concealer is just way too good. It is similar to foundation but thicker, and it can be used to hide different pigments by blending the imperfection into the surrounding skin tone. So for today I am using this Makeup Revolution the Matte Effect Cover and Conceal Concealer, which is completely creamy in texture but not too soft that the bullet gets damaged or broken under slightest pressure. It is a complete matte finish concealer, which is a plus point for me, and the blend capacity is just awesome. With one or two strokes of the finger, it blends out completely with natural finish and also gives a no cakey effect at all. Blending it is in few seconds job, and you don't even need to get hold of a concealer brush or a beauty blender. It is a fragrance free product, which makes it good for under eye dark circles too. For my comeback, I am using this Sugar As Nude As It Gets SPF 15 Compact in the shade 02 Cappuccino Light Medium. What I love about this product is that it gives my skin a natural, luminous yet matte finish, which is ultra lightweight velvet formulation. It protects my skin with patent screen tech technology, while SPF 15 provides UVA and UVB protection. It is super light on my skin with excellent shading, velvet finish with homogeneous application, and most importantly, it is paraben free and oil and mineral oil free. It has also antioxidant benefits in it, so it is a multitasking compact for me. Next, I'm using this 8's contour powder palette in order to define my eyes. I am picking up this dark brown shade from this palette with the help of an angular brush and will be applying onto my eyebrows in order to define my eyebrows. Defining our eyebrows is a very crucial part of our makeup. We shouldn't skip this step, as because defining our eyebrows can change the look of our entire face. Because eyebrows frame our eyes, and depending on their shape, we can cause ourselves look angry, tired, old or soft. Or you can also manage looking youthful and well rested. While working on your eyebrows, make sure to work in short and upward hair strokes and begin to fill the inside of your brow, and then draw a sharp line on the bottom edge to define the shape. And that's it. With the help of a sponge eyeshadow brush, I am picking up this lighter color from the same contour palette, and I will be applying it onto my eyelids in order to give a perfect base for my eyeshadow to work. So in order to get that perfect eye makeup, I am taking the help of this cello tape. You can also use scotch tape. So I am putting it under my eyes in the manner shown in the video, so that it doesn't spoil my eye makeup and my eyeshadow does not spread here and there. And of course, if there is any fallout, then it helps in not falling the fallouts onto my under eye area, and just it picks up the product. In order to complete my two-tone smoky eye makeup today, I'm using this smoky palette from Shivana. It has beautiful 6 color. From there, I'm picking up this matte black color, which is highly pigmented and smooth and buildable. So whenever I go for a smoky look, I used to take this pigment, and I'm applying the, you can see how pigmented it is. So I am applying it with the help of the sponge applicator given with the palette itself. So these palettes are basically the dupe of NYX palettes and completely share the same names. This palette have a sponge applicator tip which is decently quality and no complaints. So at first I have deposited the color on the outer corner of my eye, and then I am just smudging the product into the middle of my eye, and I will be working there till there. I will be not working the product into the inner corner of my eye. I will be just applying the product on the outer corner and working it till the middle of my eye. So once done, I am taking a flat eyeshadow brush in order to blend the product nicely so there are no sharp edges in it. And once done, then I will be applying the second color on my eyelids. For the second color, I am using this Essence 3D Duo eyeshadow, and with the help of a flat eyeshadow brush, that is the same brush, I am picking up the color. This is yellow color, cute little sparkling yellow color from it, and with the help of that flat eyeshadow brush, I will be depositing this as a yellow color onto my inner corner of my eyes and walk it to the middle of my eyes. In order to continue the smoky effect onto my under eye also, I am picking up this white color, that is white color, and I am blending it with the jet black color that I have picked it to earlier, and then applying onto my lower lash line so that the smoky eye look continues under my eyes also. So next I'm using this Hilary Rodha liquid eyeliner pen in order to draw a perfect wing eyeliner. I have already done a tutorial on how to draw a perfect wing eyeliner. If you have not yet watched it, then do hit on that I button above, or you can also check for the link in the description box. And if you have watched my earlier tutorials, then makeup tutorials, then you have known that how much I am in love with this eyeliner pen, because it makes drawing a wing eyeliner and much more easier. So once done with my eye makeup, I will be removing the cello tips from my face, and with the help of a powder brush, I will be just blending the area in order to remove the sharp edges of the cello tips there. So today I will not be contouring my face. I will be just bronzing my face. I am not using the sponge provided with it. I will just use my powder brush and I will swirl the brush over the bronzing pearls and then draw the perfect tree onto my face in order to get that shadowed look on my face. I will be also applying this onto the jawline in order to hide the double chin, and of course on the side of the nose in order to get the pointed nose look. For highlighting my face, I am using this bronzer white eye pencil. If you have watched my earlier videos, then you would have came to know that how much I love this pencil for highlighting my face. It just gives the perfect highlighted looks. So I am applying it on the highest point of my face, that is my cheekbones, then on the forehead, nose tip, and of course chin, and on above my cupid's bow. Then with the help of the same powder brush, I will blend it in order to remove that sharp edges of the lines. So in order to end my eye makeup, I am using this Sugar Lash Love Limitless Mascara in the shade 01 Black with a Bang. And this shade name is Black with a Bang. I really expected it to be extremely black or something, but it's actually is a normal black mascara. I love the fact that this mascara does not contain any fibers or something like Maybelline, the Magnum Barbie mascara, because they are really difficult to remove and the fine fibers in the mascara get into my eyes and irritate them so much. So I love that mascara, that there is no such thing in this mascara. It is pretty safe to be used on my sensitive eyes and with contact lenses too. It doesn't cause any eye irritation or watering of eyes. The mascara is decently pigmented and it takes 2 to 3 swipes to show up proper mascara effects on the eyes. So last but not the least, for my lipstick, I'm going for Bella Vosti, the Perfect Pout Sheer Cream Last Lipstick in the shade 14 Love It. It is a matte finish lipstick and I love it a lot because of its pinkish tinge, which gives a natural look to my lips. And of course, I'm not going for a darker lipstick today, as I have gone for smoky eyes, and a smoky eyes and a darker lip is a bad combination for me, I think. So I'm going for a light color pink lipstick, and you can change your lipstick color if you want to go for darker lipstick and more broad look. So that's it for the video today, and do let me know how you like this makeup tutorial, how easy it was to follow. And of course, if you like it, then do smash that subscribe button down below and do hit that like button and do share the video with your friends and relatives. Sharing is caring, and of course subscribing to a channel and liking a video or sharing a video is completely free, but it means a lot to me, and keep sharing is what the motive I follow. And of course, till my next video, love you, take care, bye, and stay tuned to Anks Cadbury for the upcoming videos. Hello Nesties, in this video at times you may find me stammering or feeling very low because I am having blisters in my tongue and I am unable to speak and I am having very much pain while speaking, but I tried my level best to record this video for so in certain times you may be seeing that or hear listening that the certain pronunciation are not clear because it's very painful on both the sides of my tongue, there are blisters. So hope you don't mind, and for that pain I am going through, please hit that like button and do share this video with your friends and relatives. Until my next video, love you, take care, bye.